Now, children living in the poorest areas are three times more likely to die in childhood or adolescence. And Maori and Pacific children and young people are more likely to die compared to others. There's some of the sobering findings from the Child and Youth Mortality Review Committee. They were released this week. So joining me for our Talanoa is Dr Jemaima Tiatia-Seath. Thank you for joining us, an expert in mental health. First of all, one of the reports says suicide is the leading cause of death for adolescents. What do you have to say about that, especially regarding our Pacific community?
In terms of our Pacific communities, I guess the biggest hurdle was the huge inequities that exist for our young people. A 2012 Pacific Youth Health Survey across secondary schools in New Zealand, we found that Pacific young people were three times more likely to attempt suicide and two times more at odds of reporting low moods. So clearly we're seeing that the current system or current frameworks aren't working. And so I guess now's an opportunity for New Zealand, especially with the Mental Health Inquiry and Addictions Inquiry, to change the game. And so what we need then is more of Pacific-infused solutions that resonate with our young people.
Okay, so you're one of, I know, two on this panel, and you'll be reviewing what's happening. You're saying what the system at the moment is broken, or what, is there not enough funding that's been given to the Pacific solution or work that's already been done out there in mental health?
Funding is absolutely a contributor to current frameworks not working. And poverty is another issue that is hugely impacting our Pacifica families, which then impacts our young people. The education system, we need more, I guess, or less gatekeeping and enabling these types of programs that work out in the community to be able to be implemented in our schools. Earlier intervention. So we need to be nabbing these opportunities to mould our Pacifica young people at early childhood stages. Okay. And then I guess hearing the community voices is absolutely key to this mental health inquiry. What works for Pacific, and that needs to be foregrounded, because currently right now all we're hearing is a lot of mainstream things and a one-size-fits-all. There are models out in the community for both Māori and Pacific that are flourishing, that are doing amazing things to turn the game around, and we need to hear that those types of narratives.
What else do you think, from what you have seen that is working, what kind of stories are there out there that is going well? There's some kind of, you know, examples or frameworks that you can see?
You have organisations like, for instance, off the top of my head, the whānau, Vaka Tautua, Levā, that are completely emerged in Pacifica, everything that is Pacifica. And so I think as a first point of contact, those should be people that we know that can disperse or disseminate our messages a lot more quicker. In terms of what's working, it's our collective our collective value base, our respect, all those traditional concepts that need to be revived, and making that, I guess, connection with our young people.
If there was, say, a young person watching, or even families watching, who've got a teenager in their family, what would you say to them in terms of supporting our young people, maybe who are, you know, dealing with mental health issues around suicide?
I think we need to destigmatise the feelings around mental illness. Okay. It's more of a changing that, even the term itself, from illness to wellness. Mm. We need to be bringing that more to the forefront, as I said. A lot more communication amongst our families, a lot more mental health literacy, and which enables us to see when our loved ones aren't doing too well. It's particularly after the death of a suicide, of someone who's died by suicide, we need to be able to support those people that are left behind.
Okay. Jemaima, I know we've just started touching on it. The inquiry, you want people to put submissions in as well. And we'll put links up as well on our Facebook page so people know where to go as well.